Hey guys, I'm super excited for today's video. We're going to be checking out Descript Overdub. You may be familiar with Descript. It's like an all-in-one podcasting and audio editing tool. It also does voice transcriptions, which is really great. But they have this other feature called Overdub, which is a text-to-speech feature. So they have stock voices, but you can also record your own voice, give a sample to Descript, and it uses AI to generate your voice back to you. So you have text-to-speech of your own voice. And I'm super excited to try this. This Descript Overdub review is part of a bigger review I'm doing where I'm actually getting a custom avatar made by Synthesia. So you're going to be able to see me as a deep fake custom avatar. And then Descript provides the voice. But that's not the only reason I'm excited for Descript. A lot of times when I'm recording here for my YouTube videos, sometimes like maybe I'll misspeak. And so what I have to do during the editing process is re-record the voiceover that I messed up on and then dub it back into my videos. And it would be so nice just to have a text-to-speech option so I don't have to do that again. It might be really time-saving. So we're gonna see if my AI voice sounds at all like my real voice, how natural it is. And we're actually going to try to generate a text-to-speech voiceover and drop it in to one of my YouTube videos and see if it sounds natural and passable. All right, let's just dive right into it. So right now I'm on the free trial of the pro plan, but here is the pricing structure for Descript. You can see here that the Overdub has a 1,000-word vocabulary for the free trial. For the creator tier, it's also 1,000 words at $12 a month. But then the pro version is $24 a month and an unlimited vocabulary. Now, if you want to try Descript for yourself, I'll drop a link in the description. Now, once you sign up for it, you have to download the app. And this is what the app looks like. I'm going to hit this blue button here, create new voice. I'm just going to name the voice Jen. And this is where you create your own voice in Descript Overdub. Now you can record your own voice right here into the Descript app, and they actually provide these training scripts for you to read from. And they even go up to 30 minutes in length. Descript does recommend at least 10-minute reads for your AI voice. So you could use the record feature, but luckily for me, I have lots of samples of my own voice because I pretty much talk all the time here on YouTube. So what I did was I opened up a 11-minute project in Final Cut Pro and just exported that recording as an audio file. I made it a WAV file, and I'm just gonna drag that WAV file right here into the app. And I can set my transcription language. I'm gonna leave it as English. And it says that my transcription will be ready in a few minutes. That actually only took about 30 seconds. And I'm just gonna do a quick scan through my transcription to make sure that it looks pretty accurate. Now I'm gonna hit this blue button here called Submit Training Data. And now I have to record myself saying this consent form. We are definitely living in the future here. You can't just sign it, you have to record your own voice. I hereby verify that I, Jen Jaeger, am currently speaking. And I get a message that my voice is now training and that they'll email me when it's done. Through the tutorials I watched earlier, I know that it could take between 2 and 24 hours to get my voice back from Descript. So I'll see you guys in a little bit, either later this afternoon or tomorrow. Okay, it's the next day. It took about 15 hours to get the email back from Descript saying that my Overdub voice was ready. I have not listened to it yet, but I'm super excited, a little nervous. Let's check it out. All right, so I think what I need to do is start a new project, which I guess I can do here at the bottom of the screen or over here with this blue button. Kind of confusing. I think I want to start writing. I'm going to click speaker. Okay, this is where I select myself as the speaker. And then I guess I hit the play button. I'm confused. I don't hear anything. Oh, wait, look, waveforms have appeared. So I guess it takes a second to generate the audio once you've typed it in. That's totally fine. Let's just listen to it. I'm a little nervous. Let's hear what this voice sounds like. I mean, that sounds like me. Doesn't that sound like me? Let's hear what this voice sounds like. I think the inflection is off, but that is 100% my voice. That's a little scary. I even added an exclamation point at the end to try to, like, you know, tweak the inflection a little bit, and I don't feel that that's reflected in this text-to-speech voiceover. Let's listen one more time. Let's hear what this voice sounds like. I think that's pretty amazing and a little scary. I'm pretty impressed with that. All right, but let's do the real test, which is that real-life scenario where I fumble something while I'm recording one of my YouTube videos and I want to go back in and fix it without having to re-record everything through my camera mic again. Let's see if it matches the sound of the camera mic. I've transcribed a quick sentence from an existing real-life video. And I'm just gonna paste that line in here. Scroll down in the inspector window to find the 3D text menu. Okay, this is wild. Okay, so now I'm gonna hit the publish button. Is that the next step? All right, it's going to give me a WAV file, which is nice. And let's bring this into Final Cut and really see if it holds up with my original audio. All right, so here's the original audio. Scroll down in the inspector window to find the 3D text menu. And let's bring in that overdub voice. Okay, what I'm first noticing is that the length of the generated voice from Descript is significantly shorter than the original audio, which is fine because, you know, when I'm talking and I'm thinking, like sometimes I leave gaps between my words. So it's nice that it kind of tightens it up. So let me mute the original audio. You can see it's grayed out there if you're not familiar with Final Cut. And then this clip right here is our WAV file from Descript. I want to pick something not too chunky and you'll see why later. All right, let's scroll down in the inspector window to find the 3D text menu. Now, if you're not seeing all of these details here, knowing myself and knowing the way I speak, I do think that the inflection in my like very astute hearing isn't quite right the way I would say it, but I don't think anybody else would notice the difference, like ever. This is such a helpful tool. This could be a game changer for me with my editing. I'm like really surprised by this. Let's just do one more just to see. In total, I got 7 proposals in a day, and of those 7, I selected 3 I wanted to work with. I think I have too many commas. I'm gonna remove a couple of these commas and see how it sounds. In total, I got 7 proposals in a day, and of those 7, I selected 3 I wanted to work with. All right, let's export it and drop it in and see how it sounds. First, let's listen to the original audio. In total, I got 7 proposals in a day, and of those 7, I selected 3 I wanted to work with. Okay, that's what I actually sounded like when I recorded this. Let's listen to the Descript overdub. About their pricing, maybe a little bit about their creative vision. In total, I got 7 proposals in a day, and of those 7, I selected 3 I wanted to work with. I'm really excited about the 3 designers I chose. I mean, it's uncanny. Like I said, I can tell the difference, but I don't think anybody else would know the difference. So what are my final thoughts on Descript Overdub? I mean, obviously I'm really impressed. I don't think that's a surprise. I think this voice 1000% sounds like me. The one critique I would have for Descript is that the UI, the user interface, is not good. I find it super hard to navigate. Everything's just very white. And I find that when like I'm using an app, that if there's like brighter colors where it kind of draws my eye about where I'm supposed to click, I think that would be really helpful and to make Descript a little bit more user-friendly. I don't think the UI is good at all, and I see a lot of room for improvement, but that's okay because the basis of the technology is a runaway hit as far as I'm concerned. And I'm really excited for next week's video where I pair this voiceover with my custom-made avatar from Synthesia. This is gonna get real weird. So if you're not subscribed, make sure that you subscribe so you don't miss that video. If you guys wanna check out Descript Overdub, I will link to it down below. Thanks for hanging out with me today. I picked out some other videos I know you're gonna love, and I'll see you again.